dear students, welcome for today's video lecture of Ganit Pravinya. In today's lecture, we are going to learn the important concept, that is prime factors. Prime factors, okay? So first of all, I'll explain about this name of the concept. Prime factors means what? See, the word prime, we have learned the prime numbers. If you remember, we have learned the prime numbers in one of the previous lecture, okay? Now, what is mean by prime numbers? See, the numbers which are divisible by exactly two numbers. The numbers which are divisible by exactly two numbers. Which are those two numbers? One and that number itself. One and that number itself. Okay? So, a number or the numbers which are divisible by one and that number itself, they are called prime numbers, okay? And you have written in the all the prime numbers between 1 to 100 in your notebook, I think, okay? So, see, the first prime number is, when we say prime numbers, the numbers which are divisible by 1 and that number itself, that is, these numbers come in the table of 1 and that number itself, okay? Means its factors are only 2, 1 and that number itself. So, which are the such prime numbers between 1 to 100? See, the first prime number is, first and smallest prime number is 2. Because 2 comes in table of 1 and 2 itself. The next prime number is 3. Correct? Then there is 5. Then 7. Understood? Then there is 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, 31, 37, and so on. You will get such 25 prime numbers between 1 to 100. You have to keep it in mind, just some of these to find the prime factors. Okay? So, 2 is the first prime number. Remember, 2 is the first prime number. Understood? Also, 2 is the only even prime number. See, all other prime numbers are odd. If you remember, we have learned odd numbers and even numbers. Even numbers means the numbers which ends with 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. Okay? And odd numbers which ends with 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. So, all the rest prime numbers, rest of all prime numbers are odd. Okay? And the 2 is the only even prime number. Understood? 2 is only even prime number and the smallest and first prime number. So, some of these prime numbers, keep it in mind, because we are going to use them to find prime factors. Understood? Now, these are the prime numbers, you understood. Factors means divisors. Factors means divisors. For example, see, if you have, we have to find divisors of 12. How we find divisors of 12? We see the 12 in is which table? First pair of the divisors of 12 will be 1 into 12 itself. 1 into 12, correct? Secondly, 2 is also 12 is also in table of 2. That is 2, 6 are 12. It is also in table of 3. 3, 4 are 12. Again, it is, see, it is in table of 1. That means it is in table of 12 also. It is in table of 2 and it is in table of 6 also. 12 is in table of 3 and it is in table of 4 also. So, all these, the factors of 12 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. So, all these are factors of 12 or divisors of 12. Okay? So, this is meaning of factors and prime means these prime numbers. So, here we have to find prime factors. Prime factors means these factors, if you will see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 12, they include all the numbers, all the natural numbers, okay? We have to find only prime factors. We have to find only prime factors of the given number. Understood? Prime factors means the factor should be out of these prime numbers. The factor should be out of these prime numbers. It can be 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, not other than these prime numbers. Understood? So, they are called, they will be called as the prime factors. So, how to find those prime factors? Let's learn. So see, we will take example of 12 only. First example we will take of 12. We'll take 16, we'll take 20, okay. So let's find first prime factors of 12. Pay attention carefully, because this is the most important concept which we are going to use it many times while solving the sums, okay. So let's find first prime factors of 12. Remember, we have seen only factors in which the factors are all natural numbers, and this is the another concept, prime factors or prime divisors, in which the divisors or factor must be only prime numbers out of these, okay. So to find prime factors of 12, let's arrange 12 this way, right here 12, okay. Now our first prime number is 2. So let's check whether 12 is divisible by 2. Means let's check whether 12 comes in table of 2. Now here you can use the divisibility test, or we have to use divisibility test to check whether 12 is divisible by 2 or not. Now see, in the 12, last digit is 2. So what is divisibility test of 2 says? The divisibility test of 2 says, if the last digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then that number is divisible by 2. So here in 12, the last digit is 2, or once place digit is 2, that means it will be divisible by 2. And when you will divide 12 by 2, as 12 is divisible by 2, so what we have to do? Write 2 here, okay, and divide 12 by 2. So you know that when we will divide 12 by 2, what answer we will get? 2 6 are 12. Okay, so that 2 6 are 12. Where you write 6? Here. 2 6 are 12. Understood? Again, draw one line below 6. Now, there is 6. Here also, think by which prime number 6 is divisible. Now the smallest prime number is 2, so always we have to start with the 2. If the given number is not divisible by first prime number, then move towards the next. Okay, so first check whether 6 is divisible by 2 or not. And if you'll say the table of 2, then yes, there is 6 in table of 2. That means 6 is divisible by 2. So write 2 here and divide 6 by 2. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6, correct? So where you write 3, 2, 3s are 6. So where you write 3? Here. 2, 3s are 6. Fine. Again, draw one line here below 3. Now see here, now we have to divide 3 by the prime numbers. But if you see, 3 is only prime number. 3 is only prime number, right? So it will be divisible by 3 itself, because you know that prime numbers are divisible by 1 or 3 itself, the number itself, okay. And 1 is not prime number, so 3 is divisible by 3 itself. So 3 1s are 3. So when you will get 1 here, stop there, because the prime factors are finished. So these 2, 2 and 3. So the prime factors of 12 are 2, 2 and 3. So how to write that? This way. 2 into 2 into 3. Because see, 3 2s are 6, 6 2s are 12. 3 2s are 6, 6 2s are 12. Understood? So you have to write the prime factors in the form of multiplication. 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3. So these are the prime factors of 12. Understood? Let's find the prime factors of 16. Same way. Arrange 16 in this form. Okay, now let's check whether 16 is divisible by first prime number, that is 2. So, if you check the divisibility test of 2, the last digit in the 16 is 6, correct? And when the last digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then that number is divisible by 2. That means 16 is a yes. 16 is divisible by 2. So write 2 here. And divide 16 by 2. 2 8s are 16, correct? Because 16 is there in the table of 2. So 2 8s are 8 right here below 16. And draw one line. Now we have to divide 8 by the prime number. So 8 is divisible by, is 8 divisible by first prime number, that is 2?
Yes.
So write 2 here and divide 8 by 2. 2, 4s are 8, correct? So 4 right here. Again draw one line. We have to keep on dividing by prime number till you till we get 1 at the end. 1 here, okay? So now see, 4 is divisible by, is 4 divisible by first prime number 2?
Yes.
So write 2 here and divide 4 by 2. 2 2s are 4, correct? 2 2s are 4. Understood? Now remain here 2. We have to divide 2 by prime number. So 2 is divisible by 2 itself. So 2 divided by 2, answer is 1. 2 1s are 2. So you got here 1. That means prime factors of 16 are finished now. So prime factors of 16 are, prime factors of 16 are 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. See, 4 times multiplication of 2. 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16. Remember once again, prime factors you have to write in the form of multiplication. Prime factors of 16 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. See, 4 times 2. Understood? Let's solve the next example. Let's find the prime factors of 20. Same way, arrange 20 this way. Now see, always we have to start with the smallest prime number. That is, smallest prime number is 2. If the given number is not divisible by 2, then check by next prime number, that is 3. If it is not divisible by 3, then check by next prime number 5. If it is not divisible by 5, then check by 7. Okay? But you don't have to take numbers here other than prime numbers when you are going to find prime factors. When you have to find prime factors, you are not allowed to take here the numbers other than these. Other than these prime numbers. Understood? So see here 20. We have to find prime factors of 20. Let's check by first prime factors, prime number 2. So its last digit is 0, that means it will be divisible by 2. So write 2 here and divide 20 by 2. 2 tens are 20, correct? 2 tens are 20. If the number which is here, it is, if it is more than tens are, because we have recited table till tens are, 2 tens are, right? So if the number is greater, more than tens are, then what you have to do, you have to take rough page and you have to divide there. And then whatever quotient you will get, that you have to write here. Okay. So you see 2 tens are 20. Finished. Now let's divide 10 by prime number. So 10 is, the first prime number is 2. Is 10 divisible by 2? Yes, because last digit is 0. So it is divisible by 2. 2 fives are 10, correct? And 5 is divisible by which prime number? Is 5 divisible by 2? See, 5 is prime number itself. So it will be divisible by that number itself. 5 ones are 5. It will not be divisible by 2 or 3. It will be divisible by 5 itself, because it is prime number itself. Understood? So 5 ones are 5. Finish here. 1 we got at the end. Finished. So prime factors of 20 are 2 into 2 into 5. See, 5 2s are 10, 10 2s are 20. Understood? So this way we have to find prime factors of the given numbers. Now pause this video and write this in your notebook. We will see some more examples. Let's solve some more examples of prime factors. See the next example. 96. Find the prime factors of 96. Okay. So as we, you know that first we need to arrange 96 in this way. Now The first prime number is 2. So we have to check whether 96 is divisible by 2 or not. So see here. Now see, the numbers are greater. So here you have to use the divisibility test to check whether the given numbers are divisible by the 2 or 3, whatever. Okay. So first, as first prime number is 2, we will check whether 96 is divisible by 2 or not. So, as according to the divisibility test of 2, what divisibility test of 2 says, if the unit's place digit of the number is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then the given number is divisible by 2, right? So, see, in the 96, unit's place digit is 6. That means, according to divisibility test of 2, it is divisible by 2. Once it is confirmed that yes, it is divisible by 2, then write 2 here and we will divide now 96 by 2. 96 divided by 2. So see here, 2, 4 is 8. 9 minus 8, 1. 6 will come down, become 16. 2 8s are 16. Okay. So when we divided 96 by 2, what answer we got? 48. So that 48 quotient right here. Understood? Same process we are going to do with the 48. Same process we are going to do with the 48. Let's check the 48 is divisible by first prime number 2 or not. Now yes, last digit of 48 is 8. That means it is also divisible by 2. So I am writing 2 here and let's divide 48 by 2. See now, first we will divide to 4. 2, 2 are 4, correct? So 4 minus 4 is 0. Let's bring 8 down. 8 is also divisible by 2. 2, 4 is 8. So answer is 24. So 48 divided by 2 is 24. Clear? Next, let's find the prime factor of 24. See, again 24 is divisible by 2 or not? Yes, it is divisible by 2 because the last digit of 24 is 4. That means it is divisible by 2. So, once it is confirmed that yes, 24 is divisible by 2, so then write here 2. And let's divide 24 by 2. 2 ones are 2, correct? 2 minus 2 is 0. 4 will come down. 2 2s are 4. 12. 24 divided by 2 is 12. See, if possible, you can directly divide here also, if possible. See, now see, there is 24. You can write this way, 2 1s are 2 and 2 2s are 4. Okay? If you are able to do the calculation in your mind, then you can divide here also. You need not to do on the rough page. Directly you can divide here also, but you have to be aware because for this, your mind calculation should be perfect. Understood? Now 12. Is it divisible by 2? Is 12 divisible by 2? Yes. So write here 2 and divide 12 by 2. 2 6 are 12. Correct? Again 6 is there. It is also divisible by 2. 2 3 are 6. Now we got here 3. Now 3 is not divisible by 2 because 3 is prime number itself. So it will be divisible by itself, 3 itself. So 3 ones are 3. Once we get here 1, stop there. Our prime factors are finished. So the prime factors of 96 are, now directly I am writing here, 96 is equal to 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 multiply by 3. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 times 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 1, 3. Okay. So, 3 2s are 6. 6 2s are 12. 12 2s are 24. 24 2s are 48. 48 2s are 96. So, these are the prime factors of 96. Remember or keep it in mind. See, prime factors are from prime numbers only. There are not other numbers like 4 or 6 or 8. Like these numbers are not there. There are only prime numbers. So, see, while taking here, you have to take only prime numbers as a factors. Understood? Let's solve next. 70. Now see. First we'll check by 2. 70 now see last digit is 0, that means it is divisible by 2. So write 2 here and divide 70 by 2. Or 2 threes are 6. 7 minus 6 1, 0 will come down, became 10. 2 5s are 10. So 70 divided by 2, 35. Understood? Now see here. There is 35. Now see 35, our first prime number is 2. Is 35 divisible by 2? Is 35 divisible by 2? No, because the last digit is 5. Okay, and when the number can be divisible by 2? If last digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then it will be divisible by 2. And here last digit is 5, so 35 is not divisible by our first prime number. Now since it is not divisible by 2, we will check whether it is divisible by 3 or not. Now what is divisibility test of 3 says? The sum of the digits. The sum of the digits should be divisible by 3. Then the whole number is divisible by 3. Now see, a sum of the digit is 3 plus 5. 5 plus 3 is 8. And 8 is not divisible by 3. That means 35 is not divisible by 3 also. Okay. Now let's, as it is not divisible by 2, not divisible by 3. So let's check whether it is divisible by 5. Now here we have to use divisibility test of 5. Okay. And what does divisibility test of 5 says? If the ones place digit is 0 or 5, then the number is divisible by 5. Now if you will see here, last digit is, or ones place digit is 5, that means it is divisible by prime number 5. So let's write 5 here and divide 35 by 5. So if you divide 35 by 5, see, 5 sevens are 35. 5 sevens are 35. So we will write 7 here. 5 sevens are 35. Now there is 7. So 7 will be divisible by which prime number? 7 is prime number itself. So it will be divisible by 7 only, not by any other number. 7 will be divisible by 7 only. So 7 ones are 7. Okay. Finished. 1 came here, finished. So prime factors of 70 are, or 70 is equal to 2 into 5 into 7. 2 into 5 into 7. See, once again, in these factors there are prime numbers only, 2, 5 or 7. 2, 5 and 7. These are prime numbers only, not other than prime numbers. Understood? Take care. 7, 5 is a 35, 35, 2 is a 70. So 2 into 5 into 7 are the prime factors of 70. Once again, remember that prime factors are written in the form of multiplication. Okay. Let's take one 3-digit number, 132. Let's find prime factors of 132. Don't worry, the number may be 4-digit or 5-digit or 6 digits. You can find prime factors easily. Don't worry, just you must know the divisibility test. We have learned divisibility test, and we are now going to apply the divisibility test here to find the prime factors. Okay. So 132. Our first prime number is 2, so we have to start with the 2. As according to the divisibility test of 2, last digit should be 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. Now here last digit is 2, that means it is divisible by 2. So write 2 here. And let's divide 132 by 2. Now first we'll divide to 13. 2, 6 are 12. Correct? 3 minus 2, 1. 1 minus 1, 0. Let's bring 2 down. 2, 6 are 12 again. So answer is 66. See, when we divided 132 by 2, we got answer 66. Okay. Now let's divide 66 by prime number. Now 66 is divisible. Is 66 divisible by our first prime number 2? Yes, because here also last digit is 6. So see, 2, first we'll divide 6, right? 2, 3 is 6, and here also 2, 3 is 6. So we got here 33. Now 33 is divisible by which prime number? Is 33 divisible by our first prime number 2? No, because last digit is 3. So as, since it is not divisible by 3, let's check whether it is divisible by 3. Since it is not divisible by 2, let's check whether it is divisible by 3 or not. Now according to the divisibility test of 3, we want sum of the digits divisible by 3. So see, sum of the digit is 3 plus 3, 6, correct? And 6 is divisible by 3. That means this 33 must be divisible by 3. So I am writing 3 here. See, if you divide 33 by 3, what answer you will get? 3, first, as a first we will divide to this 3, right? So 3 ones are 3, and again there is 3, so 3 ones are 3. Then we have got 11. Now 11 will be divisible by which prime number? 11 itself, because 11 is prime number itself, so it will not be divisible by any other number. So 11 is divisible by 11 itself. 11 ones are 11. Finished. So 132 is equal to, or prime factors of 132 are 2 into 3 into 11. Okay, 11 threes are 33, 33 twos are 66, and 66 twos are 132. So this way we have to find prime factors of the given numbers. Understood? Once again I repeat, prime factors means in those factors there must be only prime numbers. Understood? The only factors are different and prime factors are different. Okay? So hope you have understood this. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Some examples I am going to give you for homework. See here, I am writing here. Okay, so these three examples you have to do as a homework. Find prime factors of these three numbers, okay? So in this concept, if you have any doubt, you are free to ask. Till that, thank you and have a nice day.